In this video, we'll look at using Cohera 3D Mesh to create meshes from our 3D laser scans. Click the Scans folder, open Scans, and I have 9 scans here I will add to the project. I'm going to choose a subsample level of every 2x2. Click OK. And then take the scans folder and drag and drop it into the scene window. Once that is done, I will navigate to the area I wish to mesh. We have this hydroplane in the scan data here, and that's what I would like to use to create a mesh. So meshes are pretty simple. Just you use the selection tools. For example, let's grab a piece of this floor here. Okay, so you select an area of the scan data, go to Models, Meshing Tools, New Mesh Set, and then generate your mesh. Let's go ahead and remove that. And let's clear our selection. So back to the hydroplane, I am going to use the polygon tool and I am going to select around the border. And then when I'm ready to complete my selection, I'll double click with the left mouse. I'm going to take the selection visibility and just view the selected points. So that will hide everything outside of my selection. Let's reduce the subsample level by putting a lower number there. And that will increase the detail, give us a little more data here. So I don't want to mesh this whole thing here. So now I am going to use the selection tool to begin removing some of the selected points. So in the same way where you select points, this time, before you make that double click, hold down the control key on your keyboard and then double click, and that will remove points from the selection. So again, just clicking and then hold down the control key and double click. If you're using the box select, drag a box, and before you click to complete it, hold down control, and that will deselect those points. So I'll pause the video for a moment and I'll finish cleaning this up a little bit. So once I'm finished cleaning up my selection so that only the hydroplane is included in the selection, we'll go to Models and Meshing Tools. I'm going to click New Mesh Set and I'm going to rename that to Hydro, and then I will tab out of this field. And the name here changes to Hydro. Okay, so using a subsample of 4, let's go ahead and generate a mesh. Now we see the selected points and the mesh inside that selection. So I'm going to switch over to Scene Explorer. And the scans, I'm going to temporarily hide that so that we can just see the mesh alone. Now, if you need more detail in your mesh, you can reduce the subsample, and that's by putting a lower number there so that we have more points instead of fewer. Make sure the hydro is selected and click generate to regenerate that. So here we go. Now, going through this, looks like there's some more areas where there were points that need to be cleaned up. So right here we have some points near the window. Let's increase the point size so we can see those a little bit better. So I'm going to turn the mesh previews back on. And what I'm going to do is, using the selection tool, is just go through and deselect these points. So again, hold down control, double click. And we'll do the same here. Okay, so now when I generate the mesh, those little areas are gone. Okay, and I missed this right here too. So let's switch to orthographic view, which is right up here. And I'm going to get rid of this piece of the stand that I had left in my selection. So depending on how detailed and how accurate you want your mesh, you know, you can spend time in here cleaning up points. So I'm going to change the color of my mesh. Turn that to red. Check this box here. And I'm going to hide the scans. Switch out of orthographic view. Okay, and we can temporarily close this window and come back to it. So I just want to go through and see if I'm happy with the results. Looks like there's another small piece here that I would like to get rid of. So let's turn that back on. We'll switch back to the polygon, and you can also do that just by pressing P on the keyboard. So point polygon. We'll deselect these again, hold down control, double click. Let's go to models, meshing, select that mesh, and let's regenerate it. All right, so once you're happy with the results, you can go ahead and export this. In the demo mode, you cannot export, but if you have the paid subscription version of Cohera 3D Mesh, then you can export this as an OBJ. So the way to do that is click a destination folder, and I'll just use my scan project. And then you can combine this as a single file, so each of your scans that were in your project here that you dropped into this scene window, here's a list of the 9 scans. We can see the vertices faces for each scan. So there's actually 9 individual meshes here, 1 for each scan. So right now we can either export them separately or as a single file. Once you've selected the folder, just go ahead and click export. Okay, so that's complete. I'm going to click close. And actually, let's bring up the meshing tools again, and I'm going to delete this mesh. So I'll highlight it and click remove. Close that window. And then now let's open up an OBJ, which is going to be the one that we just exported. Source up Z. We'll wait for this progress bar to complete. Okay, so now the OBJ, the mesh here, has been added to our project. So we can drag and drop that into the scene window. Now, I'm not seeing that, and that's because it's underneath the scans folder, which I had turned off earlier. So let's turn that back on. That's a good practice to go ahead and create a new folder. Maybe call it models if you want, and then you can put that into the models folder, and then you'll have separate control over the visibility. So let's hide the scans. And there's the mesh we created. So that does it for this tutorial, and I'll have one more where we will explain the different features and settings options when creating the meshes here in the meshing tools window for Cohera 3D Mesh. Thank you.